So I have got some more post-tension 3D print tests that I'm going to do. Again, these are just my test blocks printed at 22% infill with 3 perimeter shells and 0.3 millimeter layer height. So the setup I am rigging in this video consists of two 3 millimeter steel cable tendons running through holes slash conduits 3D printed into the piece with spreader plates and wire rope grabs at either end. So here's a quick look at how this works. These are the spreader plates and the tendons. And these are the rope grabbing anchors I have made. So to stress the tendons, I will be using some pot riveters, which seem to work well. So to rig it up, I have installed the tendon with both its plates and anchored it off. And anchored it off at one end. And now I'm using the pop riveter to tension the tendon. Where I will lock it off with the rope grab and reset for another pull, which this works for now. I'm pretty happy with how cable tendons work for tensioning 3D prints, so I might develop a colleted countersunk anchor point system at some point. So that is an overview of how I stress the tendons and compress the 3D prints. I have two groups of tests that I am doing in this video. One group is straight through, and I'll also try annealing some of these post-tensioned 3D prints in the oven to see if they hold their dimensional accuracy on the X, Y, and Z axes. and I will pull test these annealed 3D prints also. The second group of tests that I am doing is group B here, which I have the tendons draped through the piece. So here is a quick view of what that looks like. As you can see, the tendons conduit is curved through the piece, and this is to create a secondary moment against the direction of the intended load, so it will push back against the direction it is being loaded in. I think the piece should deflect a bit, but that is intentional. So here I am doing my first direct tension test with no post tensioning, which failed at 64.75 kilos. This is shear slash bearing, no post tensioning, which fails at 24.3 kilos. This is post tension, pulled in direct tension, and I stopped the test at 251 kilograms because my scale only goes to 300 and I don't want to damage it. This is post tension test in shear slash bearing, and it lets go at 61.85 kilos. So with visual and tactile inspection of the destructed post-tension shear slash bearing tests, it is interesting the way the compressing force from the tendons makes cracks heal themselves. So now I'm going to anneal some test pieces. Unfortunately, this piece, I already buggered it. 100 degrees C was too much, so I changed to 80 degrees C for an hour. So here what I'm doing is, I'm just lightly gonna take some measurements and write them down so I can then double check after the annealing to make sure to see how much the dimensions have changed in the oven. So here I've got 130.18. So I'll write that on the piece. And across the X, I've got 15.25. And across the Y, I have 49.59. So now what I am going to do is I'm going to lightly post-tension these with two bits of M5 all thread, and hopefully this will, as it's annealing in the oven, stop it stretching along the Z and stop the X and Y from shrinking in on themselves. And I'm hoping this will help the piece keep its dimensional accuracy. And I'm just lightly snugging these plates down. I didn't torque them down very tight at all. I've taken the piece out of the oven, and now I'm removing the post tensioning, and I'm going to retake the measurements and see how I did. Still got 49.62, which is pretty close, like a tenth or so of a mil. Still got 15.03, so again, a tenth or so of a mil. Not enough to bother me, but on the Z, I've got 129.50, so I think I had the post tensioning done up a bit too much. I think if I just brought it down and then didn't tighten it at all, it would have worked out really well. But I think I'll do some more testing with annealed post tension 3D prints in a future video. This is my first annealed direct tension test with the post tensioning removed, and it lets go at 61.4 kilos. And this is my first shear/bearing test with the post tensioning removed, and I let go at 21.55 kilos. And this is my final test of group A with an annealed piece with post tensioning, and it let go at 59.75 kilos. This is my first post-tension test with a secondary moment drape, and it internally lets go at 215.5 kilos. And this is my last test for shear slash bearing with a secondary moment drape, and it let go at 121.55 kilos. So I was a bit surprised with some of the results I got from this round of testing. I was really disappointed with the annealed pieces. I actually saw a strength loss and not a strength gain, which was really disappointing, but I am pretty happy with the way I was able to keep the dimensional accuracy. It only really changed by about 0.2 mm. A bit more than that across the Z, but I think that's because I had it tensioned down a bit. So I think if I get the tension just right, it won't lose its dimensional accuracy across the Z when it's put in the oven. But I think I'll keep experimenting around with this when I get some time, because it does show a bit of promise. And hey, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. And don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. See you next time.